Let's start off with Neon's wall. Normally, if you throw the wall, it will be stopped by a structure, but if you aim above the structure, the wall will continue to travel. You can use this concept if you want to throw your wall to smoke off tree, for example. You can do this actually from A main. All you have to do is aim your crosshair above the A main wall here. That would be blocking it. And this same concept works anywhere on any map, like through Market, to smoke B main on Ascent. But before we get any deeper into today's guide, I need to take a quick second to remind you guys, if you want a chance at a free Valorant Battle Pass, drop a like and comment hashtag installed Valorant Tracker, who is by the way today's lovely video sponsor, and help me give back to you guys. You can use the guides tab on Valorant Tracker to learn Neon stun lineups on any map, or using the guides tab will also show you lineups or setups for every agent while you are in a live game, which is one of the reasons that I recommend using it. You can also check your lifetime stats for your account, including your agents, to see which agents you struggle with and should possibly avoid, which weapons you aren't the best with and should try to improve with, and even what maps you need to work on or that you are best at. All of this info will give you an insight on which aspects of your gameplay need the most work. It even has a match history tab to show you all of your recent games so you can visually see if you're having an off day and should possibly take the day off. The live match feature is also really cool, as you can see a visual breakdown of all the ranks and stats of your team and the other team while you're in a game with them. If you want to improve every aspect of your gameplay and rank up, check out the link in the description or pinned comment. Now let's get back to the video. You also really need to learn how to backward slide. This mechanic is such a huge part of Neon's movement, and it will make you an insanely harder target to hit. To do it, all you have to do is start sprinting forward by holding your W key and jump, and as soon as you land, hit your S key and your slide at the same time. This might be tough to get the hang of, but it's definitely going to be worth it in the long run. Speaking of slides, many people aren't aware that if you pop your Neon ult, your slide will automatically recharge. So you can use this to double slide. To do this, just sprint at them, use your slide, then pop your ult mid slide and slide again. This makes it so anyone trying to track your first slide will have a very hard time doing so and will probably net you a ton of free frags. You can also use her sprint to get onto off angles that you normally would require a ability to get onto, like double stack on Ascent. Now for Neon stun, there's a few people who use lineups so that they can stun certain angles when entering onto a site to stop the enemy from peeking, but a cool trick a ton of people don't know is the fact that if you stun underneath a surface, the top will also get stunned. For example, on Fracture, if you stunned underneath a site, anyone playing on the top of site will also get stunned. Neon's ult is also extremely strong and possibly one of the best eco weapons in the game, but I constantly see many people not using it correctly. First of all, the ultimate does more damage when you're at a closer range, so when using it, you need to use your stun and your wall to get yourself closer to the enemies and close that gap. The headshot multiplier with a Neon ultimate is also really strong, so please, when using it, aim for the head. You can basically insta-kill anyone with your ult at close range with the headshot. Now I want to show you guys a few off angles I like to play on Neon that I find are really strong. Starting off with split, you can jump from rafters on top of Nubox and hold the B main push from this off angle. Not a lot of players will expect you here, and you'll be able to catch them off guard and get some easy frag. I also like jumping from Heaven on Haven on top of Sight, and then jumping on top of the short box. Then you can kind of position yourself on top of the edge of the short box and usually get some free frags on people running up long. For Pearl, you can jump on top of default Sight box on B site and play this off angle, which is pretty strong because if they do flash or anything, you can just drop off the box and play behind it. You can also use your Neon stun by stunning above the place that you want it to hit. For example, if you wanted to stun in Hookah on Bind, you could throw your stun at the roof and it will actually bounce off the roof and stun the floor that is directly below it. Also, a ton of people don't know, but Neon is actually able to outrun a Sky ultimate. This is more of just a cool fun fact because normally you'll just break it, but if you run around the map without shooting the Sky ultimate, it will kind of just disappear over time without ever hitting you. Now I actually got one of the best Neon one tricks on YouTube to help me out with this video. So now for this next section of the guide, it's going to be covered by my friend Grumpy.
What's up guys? I'm Grumpy, also known as Grumpy on Val, and I am an Immortal 3 Neon movement player. Rem has gone ahead and asked me to come on here and talk about some more niche things that are related to Neon and her gameplay. And I wanted to just talk about the sprint ability. Obviously the sprint ability is one of her core pieces of utility, and it's one of the most important things that you want to get really good at, because in 90% of situations a sprint will change the way you play the character. Now, in order not to stretch out Rem's video too long, I'll be going over some of the basic ways that you can utilize the sprint. One thing that you guys got to keep in mind at all times is there are very little situations where you should be just sprinting. This is not a good utilization of Neon's character and her sprint ability. When you're just running, all your opponent has to do is hold wide head level, and it's a guaranteed one tap. The reason why you want to be jumping at all times is because when you're jumping around, even if you get caught off guard, your hitbox and your head are going up and down so fast that they're going to either have to flick shot you or spray you down or get very lucky in order to kill you. Now, this could be used in a lot of different situations. So let's say, for example, you are trying to retake and you have to clear this choke point. While you're typically clearing one by one to make sure that no one's going to be shooting you, you can use your sprint ability to just run past or jump past and clear all of these angles at once. The odds of someone hitting you in the head or even hitting you at all while you're sprinting and jumping past this tight little area is near impossible, unless they're, I don't know, bro, like tens. And if high rank players can't counter this, then no one can. What makes this so great is this gives you so much information through one action. With just one jump, I have cleared almost the entirety of the common angles in heaven. If I'm jumping through and I see them, I can react instantly and slide back in and try to hit the kill, right? The main thing that you want to be keeping in mind as a Neon main is you want to be throwing off timings and expectations. That's how you're going to be utilizing your movement. That's how you're going to be utilizing your stuns. That's how you're going to be utilizing your wall. It's the main mindset I want you guys to learn. This mindset applies to every single one of her abilities. For example, if you guys are familiar with my work, you're aware of this stun lineup. Why does this stun lineup work? It works because it's throwing off timing. If you're a player that's holding an elbow and you don't hear a Neon, you don't hear anyone for that matter. Let's say you're doing it off rip, right? When the round starts. The fact that you get stunned here out of nowhere will not only disorient them, but also it's undodgeable because the timing doesn't make sense. That's the whole point of Neon. If you want to get comfortable with Neon and using her abilities properly, you definitely need to learn the two types of strafes, directional strafing and rotational strafing. Now, there is a whole video about this one topic and it goes very in depth, which is why I'm not going to touch on it too much here. Going to learn about that. I have an advanced strafing guide on my YouTube channel. But the main thing you want to learn is the difference between these two strafes. Let me explain why. Let's say it's late round and you're trying to clear C in order to plant safe for your teammate. The reason you want to learn your directional and rotationals is because while you're clearing the site, you won't be looking in the direction that you're going. And in order to conserve your speed, you always have to be holding the forward direction. If I'm trying to sprint through and clear everything at the same time, I'm going to have to look around as I'm doing it. And I want to be jumping at all times, as we've previously covered, because I don't want to be an easy to hit target. And a good way to achieve that is by alternating your directional and rotational strafes in order to go in the direction that you want to without looking there. So, say I'm clearing here, I'm going around, I'm clearing. You see how I'm not looking where I'm going, but I still cleared everything. Rotational strafes are also very useful to peek in and out of smokes. So smokes and walls. Well, let's just say they're both called smokes. Let's say I have a wall here and I want to clear this area behind this wall, right? Now, if I just clear like this, the chances of me getting hit are pretty high. Probably gonna get tapped. So I want to do it while I'm jumping and moving so that it's a lot harder to hit. Now, if you do this with a directional strip only, you're not really clearing much versus clearing with a rotational strip where you can see all of the other side. You're clearing all of this area with this one motion versus only this small little section with a rotational strafe. So sometimes, depending on the situation, one strafe is a lot more useful than another. Now again, this topic is very dense and very in-depth. I have a advanced movement guide and a advanced strafe guide on my YouTube channel. If you guys want to check that out and go a lot more in detail about this, feel free to check it out.